What's up, guys? Roman from RNS Entertainment, here with part 2 of my in-depth character spotlight for Abraham Ford from The Walking Dead. If you haven't seen part 1, I'll have that up as a link in the video as well as in the description below. And if you haven't seen any of my character spotlight videos for The Walking Dead, they are in-depth analysis of a character's entire run in the comic book series, going through their role in the group, their position in the story, their relationships with other characters, everything, you know, from beginning to end. This is going to cover the entire second half of Abraham's arc in the comic books, picking up right after I left off in part 1. This is, of course, going to contain major spoilers from Abraham's run in the comic book series, and it is going to focus almost entirely on comic book Abraham. I left off part 1 of my Abraham character spotlight in the aftermath of the group's ordeal with the Hunter. Picking up after this, we see Rick and Abraham leading their now hardened group of survivors towards Washington, D.C. in hopes of the cure that Eugene has promised them. In the comic books, Eugene has been claiming to be able to speak to people in Washington, D.C. He claims that he turns this radio on every once in a while to conserve the battery so that he can speak to them, and that's how he basically knows that things are going good up there. They've actually gotten pretty close to DC at this point, and Rick wants to check the radio, you know, it makes sense, turn it on, you know, just see what's going on. And as soon as he grabs for the radio, Eugene loses it, freaks out, starts trying to struggle with Rick and get him to not mess with the radio. In the struggle, they drop it, and it turns out that there were never any batteries in it to begin with. The second Eugene admits this, Abraham blows up, and we did see something like this go down in the show, although the circumstances for Eugene admitting that he's not a scientist were very different. Abraham beats Eugene the fuck down, kicks him, punches him in the fucking face, just screaming at him, asking him how many of the stories that Eugene told him were lies. It turns out that Eugene was a high school science teacher, and Abraham's more mad at the fact that he has led several people to their death because of Eugene. You know, we saw this in the show. It was actually at a point when Abraham was about to make a decision that very easily could have led a couple of people to their deaths just in pursuit of getting Eugene to Washington faster. Finding out that his entire mission was a lie and that he's spent so much time and effort protecting a coward and a liar can't be easy for Abraham, but he does handle it a lot better in the comics than he did in the show. Definitely doesn't kneel down like a statue for hours. And afterwards, Rick approaches him, and Abraham says that he's still angry, but not because of Eugene. He's angry again because he led a couple of people to their deaths because of him, and he blames himself for it because he's the bigger man. They start discussing what to do next, and Rick actually wants to go on to Washington, D.C. He says that even if Eugene didn't know what the fuck he was talking about, there's still a chance that there are people there, or at least food that they can scavenge. Before Rick's able to finish his thought, they're approached by a random stranger, smiling with his hands up, talking about how he just wants to have a conversation. Rick and Abraham share a quick look, and suddenly Rick just wham, knocks dude the fuck down, punches him right in the face. Abraham's like, what the hell, man? That was totally not a let's attack this guy look we just shared. Rick says he doesn't care if the guy doesn't have weapons on him. He doesn't like anybody that's just walking up smiling in the zombie apocalypse. I mean, that's how the governor was. He was all smiles when they first met him. This is also the second time in a very short period of time that they're approached by random strangers in the woods. And I mean, sometimes it does turn out to be someone completely benign and harmless like Father Gabriel, but sometimes it turns out to be a governor. So Rick's not taking his chances. After introducing himself as Aaron, the man gives them a pitch about joining his community. He says that they've got a completely safe haven where things are normal. They're like they used to be. They have food, they have safety, you know, and it sounds way too good to be true. We've been here before with Woodbury and in the show even with Terminus. You know, you can't just believe people when they say shit like this. So Rick is hesitant, but the whole group outvotes him. At this point, they've been through too much, you know, they're not passing up any kind of offer. And without Eugene's, you know, plan to go to DC without any real reason to continue on, they need somewhere to go. They need something to shoot for. Rick has been out of his giving orders mode since the prison attack. You know, him and Abraham have basically been making decisions together, and the whole group unanimously decides to go. So they continue on to Alexandria. On the way there, Rick pulls Abraham aside, making sure that they're not letting down their guard. You know, anything goes on, shoot the motherfuckers in the head. So Rick's not buying this shit yet. Alexandria is an interesting area because against all odds, it actually is what it appears to be. It's a community of people that just want to live normal lives and that have found some way to band together behind these walls of metal plating. you know, in this town of Alexandria to survive. The only thing is, they're completely incompetent at everything from leadership to planning to group tactics to battle to scouting, everything. These people suck at it. Our first indication of this comes before they even get to the town. They have to end up saving the lives of some of the scouting party members from Alexandria and riding into the gates together. They end up all getting set up, and once they're introduced to the leader, they do kind of one-on-one interviews with him, where he kind of goes over the rules of the town, how things work there, and sets them up with kind of a job assignment that they, you know, mutually agree on what would be best. Rick is set up as the new sheriff slash constable figure, and Abraham is assigned to the construction crew. This group kind of goes out and gathers materials to strengthen and rebuild the walls, these big metal plates, and we'll talk more about them when Abraham actually goes out on their first assignment. He was chosen for obvious reasons, you know, he's a huge motherfucker for one thing, he's got a military background, because the construction crew also doubles as kind of sentries. You know, they kind of guard the walls, and they deal with zombies more than anybody else in the town. They're given three houses to split among their group, and Rick decides to take one house with Carl, Andrea, and Morgan, set up another house with Maggie, Glenn, Sophia, who they've adopted, and Michonne, and then Abraham, Rosita, Gabriel, and Eugene in the third house. Afterwards, Rick realizes that Abraham might not want to stay in the same house with Eugene after all the things that went on, but Abraham says that he does want to talk to Eugene. You know, they were close friends, or at least as close friends as you can be in the zombie apocalypse, before he found out that Eugene was a huge liar, so he wants to patch things up and try to fix things. But he also knows that they're not going to have to deal with this right now, because Abraham decides that they all need to sneak into one house for these first couple of days, because when they came into Alexandria, they did have to give up their weapons. This didn't go over without a lot of disagreement, and Michonne was allowed to keep her sword after she demanded to be able to. So they just want to group up in one house to make sure that they're not being split up and disarmed for a reason. Over time, the group learns to trust these people to a degree, and they try to socialize with them as well, to varying degrees of success among different characters. When Abraham is about to go out on his first assignment with the construction crew, he lets Rosita know that now that they've been living this normal life for a little while, now that they've been around people and been in a safe environment, he doesn't want to go back out there with all the zombies, you know? And I've said it before, Abraham is a big softy underneath all of his tough exterior, and Rosita is the only person he lets in to see that. When the construction crew is loading up on weapons to go out on their next run, Abraham grabs his gun, his trademark machine gun, and a guy reaches for it. He's like, "Oh, cool, when did we get this?" Abraham's like, "We didn't get anything, buddy. This is my weapon." Abraham's machine gun is just as iconic to him as Tyrese's hammer is to him. When they make it outside the wall, Abraham is told by the current leader of the construction crew, Tobin, that he's gonna have to go on a material run with this guy named Bruce. Bruce isn't a major character, but he does kind of become a friend to Abraham, and he tells Abraham that the community is a lot more fucked up than it seems to be. This is really ominous, but it really does boil down to incompetence again. Bruce has seen a lot of people get sacrificed out on the construction crew, and we're gonna get into that in a minute. We also see where Alexandria has been getting the big metal panels that they've been using for walls. They were floor panels in a construction project of a building that was never finished. So they've been sending people out to stack these panels up on a truck, bring them back to the wall, and then use them to reinforce and add on to it. When Abraham and Bruce show back up at Tobin's group, they see them being overrun by zombies. Holly gets cut off, and Tobin says that everybody else needs to stand shoulder to shoulder in a circle and just shoot outwards, and they just abandon Holly to the zombies. I mean, this is another example of how ridiculously incompetent these people are. Abraham's like, "What the fuck is a phalanx formation?" And basically, Tobin has the idea that they're gonna use ancient Roman-style formations, even though this is not a phalanx, you know, this is not actually a phalanx. It's the stupidest fucking plan, you know, it's basically protect anyone who manages to group up and just fuck everyone else, you know, just abandon them. So we can see that a lot of people have probably died in the same exact way. You know, Bruce follows orders and goes back into the group, but definitely says that, you know, we need to help them because Abraham is going over to Holly, the one that got blocked off from everybody else, and taking out zombies like a badass. And both of them are kind of just going hardcore on this fight. They take out the majority of the zombies by themselves, and the entire group is just staring like, holy shit. Immediately, Abraham blows up and calls them all cowards because they are. And Tobin fires back. He's like, we've got a system. You know, Holly, back me up. Tell him why we had to leave you to die. And she's like, are you kidding me? And knees him in the balls. And I never support that happening to anybody. But maybe in this case, I can make an exception, you know. Fuck this guy. So he's on the ground and he's still kind of like, I did what was safe for all of us. I tried to keep us safe. And Abraham's like, motherfucker, you did what was safe for you and the few people around you. Like, is that how you've been operating this whole time? You're just abandoning people left and right? How many people have gotten killed from this? So, you know, he immediately kind of takes charge. He starts telling them what to do. He's like, you're incompetent. I'm gonna run this shit now. Pick up these panels, we're gonna get them on the truck, load them up, and leave before the zombies get here. A week later, we see Tobin being called in for a meeting with Douglas, the leader of Alexandria at the time. And he's not happy with Abraham having taken over. He's like, you're taking orders from Abraham now? And Tobin's like, yeah, I'm taking orders from Abraham. And this is actually Tobin admitting he was wrong, which is nice, you know, but there's really no denying it. Things have been running way more smoothly with Abraham in charge. They're getting shit done at a way faster pace. Everybody's been safe. Abraham knows what he's doing. Tobin admits that he got a ton of people killed with his stupid tactics and that his men deserve more. They deserve Abraham. They deserve a leader from this new group because it's not just Abraham. These motherfuckers, Rick and his group, are some of the most hardcore people probably on the planet at this time. They've been out in the world. They've been dealing with cannibals and the governor and all of these hardcore crazy threats. They've had to learn to survive, and by doing that out in the wilderness for so long, they've gathered up a specific set of skills that makes them invaluable to the community, that makes them leaders within the community immediately by default. When Glenn and Heath, which is Alexandria's scout, go out on a supply run, their motorcycles and a gunshot from Rick dealing with somebody in the community draws this armed gang of thugs, you know, basically, to the outskirts of the community. They demand that they get let in. They've only got a few people, and they end up getting taken out pretty quickly. But the gunfire from the shootout with them draws a huge amount of zombies around Alexandria. Abraham rallies and leads a group to take out as many of these zombies as they can. They're going to split off into two groups, and one is going to travel along one side of the wall, one is going to travel along the other side, fighting zombies while they go and meeting in the middle on the other side. This is a big step in Abraham's evolution as a leader of these people. You know, he's used his military experience and his leadership skills in the construction crew before, but this is his first time actually leading basically the whole town. Things go really well as Abraham's part of the group circles around the walls. They're taking out zombies left and right. Holly's by his side. They're having a little fun while they do it. Glenn asks if he wants to call the last zombie they see. Abraham's like, called, and just home run swings the zombie's head off with a baseball bat. As both groups prepared around the corner on the far side of Alexandria, they hear a warning shot off by Andrea in the guard tower. As they round the corner, they're confronted with a full-fledged zombie herd, which Abraham was the first person to be talking about herds in this comic book series. He has some of the most experience with herds, and he knows to get the hell out of there. So they hightail it back to the gate, and Abraham is one of the last people through, fighting off zombies, making sure most of his people get in. Bruce is the only one who doesn't make it. He gets held out by zombies and gets bitten on the throat. Abraham has his all is lost kind of don't give a fuck face. He puts on this face anytime something really tragic that just can't be helped happens. Abraham takes it upon himself to smash Bruce's brain in with his baseball bat before Bruce is able to reanimate as a zombie. After initially getting really upset with him, Holly apologizes and just runs in for a way too personal hug, you know, saying that she was just scared. She also calls him honey, and Abraham says to not touch him like that in public, that someone might see them. This is the first indication we've gotten that Abraham and Holly have become more than friends. They've gotten very close lately, and when Abraham decides to spend time with Holly instead of Rosita when they get back, it becomes painfully obvious that Abraham is definitely accidentally cheating on her with Holly. Hurting Rosita in any way is inexcusable to me. You know, I love Rosita personally as a character. She's one of my favorite female characters in the entire series. But while the Holly-Abraham relationship may be happening at the wrong time, there is an explanation for it in a little while. I'm gonna get into that. It's not an indication that Abraham's just a complete asshole. You mean it is a fucked up move for him to get with Holly while he's still with Rosita, but there's more to it than that. Eventually, Abraham brings it to Rick's attention that the walls of Alexandria aren't as sturdy as they appear to be, or at least not all of them. See, originally, the people of Alexandria were burying the poles that are holding up these walls as support beams and filling them with concrete, but they ran out of concrete, so they've just been packing dirt around the newer ones. So a lot of these panels are actually really weak if they've got any real force leaning up against it. Enough zombies start to lean up against one of the panels that it begins to bend inwards, and they have to park a truck up against it to keep it from falling down. Eventually, while Holly and Tobin are watching the breach in the wall, not one but two panels cave in under the weight of the zombies pressed against it. Suddenly, walkers are streaming into the town, and things are breaking out into chaos. Rick shows up at the scene only to find Tobin ripped to shreds, in the chaos trying to escape and scramble and fight their way through some of the zombies to even get in touch with the rest of the town. Rick ends up watching Morgan getting bit and tries to get him to safety. During this, he's about to get attacked by a zombie himself, and he's pretty much completely helpless at this point. And Abraham, in the most epic moment, shows up with the fucking cavalry. He's like, get Morgan to safety, we got this. This is now broken out into a full-on war against the dead. There's no escaping, there's nowhere to run. This is their last safe haven. This is their fucking town. And Abraham's small group fights off the already hundreds strong of zombies that are coming in. This is a crazy battle. There's almost no way they can win. Abraham's barking out orders, and all they have to do, they have to try to hold out until more people can show up, until the reinforcements arrive. Abraham's getting madder and madder throughout this battle, hacking through zombies, just fuck, 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 and he wheels around, and suddenly Rosita's right there by his side. Don't get so worked up, killer. You're gonna give yourself a heart attack. And in that exact moment, Abraham calms down enough to rally his troops and keep fighting. Eventually, they're just overrun. They don't have enough people. And Abraham and Rosita end up running off by themselves and getting trapped inside one of the houses. While they're running away, Abraham asks if she saw anyone else and specifically asks about Holly. And the pain on Rosita's face as she says that she saw Eugene running away, what a surprise, is pretty clear that she knows exactly why Abraham asked for Holly in particular. They're now bunkered into the house together, but Abraham is no coward, and he hears and sees the sounds and sights of a massacre going on outside. All you see is Abraham's boots step out of the door, and he's like, over here, motherfuckers! And as terrified as she is, Rosita, right there, ever by his side. With Abraham back in the fray, the tide begins to turn the smallest bit just to where it's not certain death. This man has a talent for warfare. Rick is like, what happened? What changed? And all Michonne has to say is Abraham. The people of Alexandria rally and fight back. And with Abraham right in the middle of things, the herd actually starts to thin a little bit. The hundreds and hundreds of zombies that they're fighting are actually starting to go down. And this is really a war. I mean, I called it a war, and that's what it is. This is a war against the dead. This is the human population, the actual survivors, standing up and defending their homes for one of the first times in the entire series. Even Eugene, of all people, rallies and continues to fight, and Abraham, Eugene, Rosita, and Holly all fight side by side, just destroying these zombies and ending up coming out on top in the end. They are surrounded by corpses at this point, and without Abraham, none of them would have made it through. In the aftermath of this, they're trying to burn some of the hundreds of bodies that they now have. Abraham's helping burn the bodies, and they come across the corpse of the woman that Rick had been with for a little while. He had to leave her behind. He had to chop her hand off with his axe to keep her from dragging him and Carl down. So Glenn is like, you know, what do we do? And he's shocked, and Abraham's like, get rid of her before Rick sees it. Glenn still doesn't make a move, and Abraham just pops her in the head, you know, he's like, make me do everything. But it is a good little sign that he's taking care of Rick, you know, doing little things that he knew Rick did not need to see that shit. Later on, Rosita reveals to Abraham that she knows that he's been fucking Holly. Of course she knows. How could she not? Like, she's a smart girl. Rosita packs her bags and leaves him, and nobody could really blame her for it. She goes to stay with Eugene until she figures out what's going on. Abraham starts to apologize, and she's like, you know what? Apologizing isn't going to make things better. And Abraham, in another case of his foot and mouth disorder, you know, Abraham always manages to say the wrong things at the worst time. Like, when it really matters, Abraham's gonna trip over his words. He's gonna say the wrong thing. So he tells her that he's not sorry for cheating on her with Holly, but that he's sorry that he hurt her. And this is a really genuine feeling from him. He does mean this. I mean, he appreciates what she was to him and what she did for him, but he phrases it in the worst way possible. And he basically says that she's not the last woman on earth. And I mean, she's like, fuck you, and runs out. And he doesn't even, you know, he doesn't know how to phrase something like that. Basically, he's formed a genuine connection with Holly. When he met Holly, something about her just was perfect for him. And he knows that with a limited time on this earth, you know, he has to spend it with the person that he really thinks he's in love with. So, I mean, it's fucked up. It sucks for Rosita. I love her to death. But you can't fully blame Abraham for anything except not breaking up with Rosita first. He should not have cheated on her, and he realizes this. When he goes to Holly afterwards, you know, he says that he doesn't want to feel happy right now. Like, he feels horrible about what he did and would never want to hurt Rosita. When Rick and Abraham and most of the main members of the group go out on a mission, they return to find that one of the people in Alexandria has tried to rally the rest of the townspeople against Rick and his entire group, saying that they just took over by force and that they need to go, that they're the real threat. And when Rick shows back up, he's like, really? You're gonna take back the community from us? From Andrea? From Abraham? From Michonne? From me, motherfucker? Do you have any idea who you're talking to? And this is them laying down the motherfucking law. Rick is in charge here. He has been for a long time. So the townspeople fall in line, but later we see as Holly and Abraham are in bed together, she's kind of whispering in his ear saying that Abraham should be leader, that he should be making all the decisions. And I mean, she's not completely wrong, because Abraham pretty much is just as much of a leader of this community as Rick is at this point. But it kind of hints towards there being a conflict between Abraham and Rick, and I was really worried about seeing this. Nobody wants another Shane situation. You know, as great as Shane and Rick's battle was in the show, we don't want to see Abraham and Rick at each other's throats. So Abraham and Michonne end up going out to check the surrounding area, check kind of the perimeter of the town, and this is a really cool little scene before it gets intense. Just the humor between Abraham and Michonne. These are characters that haven't interacted that much, you know, in the entire series, but we do get to see Michonne's sense of humor, which is a big thing. It's always lying underneath the surface, and that's a thing with Michonne, is that she feels like people don't really understand her. You know, she's actually a very different person than just this badass chick with a sword. They end up coming across a character that becomes a major character moving forward, Paul Monroe, aka Jesus. Now, this guy's really crazy. He's really over the top. He doesn't really do weapons or firearms. He's kind of a ridiculous kung fu guy, but he's got mad skills. I mean, he takes out Abraham and Michonne, even with Abraham firing off with the machine gun and Michonne having her sword and combat skills. He ends up getting Abraham with the sword at his throat and says that, you know, he's been saying the whole time, he's like, I don't want to fight, but stop pointing weapons at me. I don't have any. But it becomes really apparent that he doesn't need any weapons. And he's like, take me to your leader. So they bring Rick, you know, Rick meets up with him and he introduces himself. He talks about two other communities existing besides Alexandria. Now, this is going into a whole area of the comic books from this point forward where there are multiple communities, multiple nations, essentially, that are kind of setting things up. And I'm going to go more into that in a lot of other videos that aren't focused entirely on Abraham. Jumping forward a bit in time, Abraham approaches Eugene Eugene and tries to set things straight between them, tries to just have a conversation with him. And Eugene is a complete and total dick. He says that him and Rosita are together and that Abraham's jealous and just is being a spiteful little asshole. And you can tell that it's just because Eugene was always jealous of Abraham. He always wanted Rosita, you know, all those times when they were all together as a group. And he's really just a spiteful little fuck in this scene. Rosita comes out after Abraham says fuck you and leaves. And I mean, it's really clear that they are not together in any capacity. She's actually really mad that he said that. Abraham and Eugene end up going on a two-man expedition to look for materials so that Eugene can manufacture ammunition for their guns. Eugene is still being pretty spiteful to Abraham, kind of in a more joking way at this point, talking about how Rick is just gonna pat Abraham on the head like a dog if they succeed this mission, saying that he's taken orders from Rick. And during this time, we see that Negan's men are stalking them. They've had one run-in with Negan's men before, and this is not good. Eventually, Abraham and Eugene come to an understanding. Eugene kind of apologizes and said that he was jealous and said that they're not together. And Abraham says that, dude, you could go after it. Go try to be with her, you know? Maybe she won't see you that way, maybe she will. But he gives Eugene his blessing, you know, and says that he wants Rosita to be happy more than anything. And while they're having a conversation, before you even realize it, before Abraham realizes it, before Eugene realizes it, a crossbow bolt comes out of nowhere and protrudes out of Abraham's eye. He continues on the sentence, and his last words before the damage sets in and he collapses is talking about how all he wants is that Rosita and Eugene and everyone could be happy. And God damn it, Abraham is down and Eugene is freaking out now, and he picks up Abraham's iconic weapon and runs back to the town. Eugene ends up cornered by Dwight and the rest of the Saviors, Negan's men. Dwight is the man with the crossbow who shot the bolt into Abraham's head. They did it in retribution for Rick making the decision to kill the first round of Negan's men that they met. Before Eugene is killed as well, Rick and the rest of the group come out and save them. They find Abraham's body being already ripped into by a zombie. Since an arrow went through his head, they don't have to worry about him reanimating, but Rick is like, we have to get him. We can't leave him out here to be eaten. So they haul the body in to the town, and Holly breaks down immediately upon seeing him. They end up all just being in a state of shock. Abraham was a figurehead in this group for so long. Right after they lost Tyrese, Abraham filled that role of right-hand man, and he was one of the best survivors that they ever had. He was a warrior, he was a general, he was an all-around good guy, and they don't know what the hell to do. Rosita is in tears, and we get her final recollection of Abraham to Eugene. She talks about how when she first met Abraham, she would kind of give more attention to strong men to get their protection, you know, kind of stuff like that, just to survive. And that when Abraham came around, she thought that he would want that as well, but, you know, he didn't. He protected her for no reason other than that he was a good guy. She says that he would have protected Eugene if he didn't lie in the first place, that he was just a great person. And, you know, it's really hard on Rosita because she knows that he didn't love her in the same way that she loved him. I mean, it grew into something serious, and she cared for him so much. I love Rosita. I felt so bad when this conversation was taking place. They hold a full funeral service for Abraham, one of the first we've gotten for any major character, and you get to see the whole town's reaction as they all break down remembering their fallen brother. Abraham was an amazing character, and he really stands for that entire section of the comic book. Like, he represents that section in a way no other one character really does. When he showed up, when his group showed up, things started to change. This was the evolution from The Walking Dead, from a mid-size, you know, type of deal with the governor and with the prison and things getting set up, to this new period of growth and change.